So we'll get started here in Photoshop, and I wanted to just show you these two images that I took photographs of. And what you can see here is I've taken a photograph of this wine glass from a side view, and I've taken a second photograph of the same wine glass on its side for a top view. And the thing that you should notice between these two images is that the camera has not moved. I've just oriented the wine glass on its side so I can get this kind of top-down view. And these rulers on the top and on the side are set to centimeters. And the reason I've done that is Maya's default units of measurement is also in centimeters. So that just makes it easier without having to change any settings. One other note about how I took these photographs is that I set this up so that the camera is far away from the wine glass, and then I used the zoom lens on the camera to zoom into the wine glass so that in essence I'm using a long lens to take this photograph. And the reason for that is that if you take a photograph of an object with a wide-angle lens, you get some distortion in there. I'll show you what I'm talking about. I've got this Wikipedia page up here about perspective distortion, and if I scroll down to this images they've got here, here's a photograph that's taken with a wide-angle lens of 18 millimeters, and you notice some of that lens distortion you're getting here. The object here in the foreground is curving a little bit, and it's being bent and distorted by this wide-angle lens. When you use a longer lens, the distortion is less, but the longer lens you use or the more you zoom in to the object, you get less distortion. So my recommendation when you're doing these kind of photographs is that you would use a long lens or zoom in as much as you can, and that way it minimizes the distortions that the lens creates. And you get a nice flat image that you can use to base your model in Maya so that you don't get too much lens distortion. So now I'm going to take both of these images, the side view and the top view, and I'm going to drag and drop those into Photoshop, and they'll open up here. I'm just going to zoom out a little bit so that you can see both of those images side by side. And I'm going to create a new document now in Photoshop. So I'll say File, New, and here in the options, I'm going to set my units to pixels. And I'll type in 1,000 pixels by 1,000 pixels, and I'm leaving it at a resolution of 72 dpi. What this is going to do for us is create a new document that is square, and we can use that to combine our top view and our side view into the same document. So I can select now my first document, and all I have to do is shift click and drag that background image into my new document, and it will appear now as a layer in this new document. I'll repeat that process for the front view. I'm going to select the layer, use shift button, and then drop it in there. So now you can see I've got two layers in this new document from the original photographs. Now that I've done that, I can close out my originals and we can work on this new document with two layers in it. I'm going to create some guides in this document that will show us exactly where the middle of the document is, from the top to the bottom and the left to the right. So if I come up here and I say View, New Guide, it brings up this dialog box, and I can start with the vertical selected, and in position I'm just going to type in 50%. And when I click OK, it creates for me a new guide that is exactly down the middle of this document. I'm going to repeat that process for the horizontal. I'll select that and again type in 50%. And now I have a set of crosshair guides that are exactly down the middle of this document. I'm going to modify the preferences of Photoshop so that the units of the ruler are set to centimeters. So I believe by default this is set to inches. So I'm going to switch that over to centimeters and click OK on that. And now my ruler across the top is now set to centimeters, and that matches the centimeters of my ruler in the photograph. After setting the ruler to centimeters, now I'm going to set the origin of the ruler in the Photoshop document to be the middle of the photograph. And I can do that by clicking up here in this white square and clicking and dragging out, so that the center of the ruler snaps to the guides, and once it's snapped to the guides, you'll notice now that the center of the photograph is set to zero on the ruler. And now I can use that to measure outward from the center so that the object in my photograph will be symmetrically aligned to the middle of the document. So I'll start the alignment process on the front layer, and that's the top layer here. With that layer selected, I can rename that to be the front layer. And I can use my move tool So I can move that photograph around. I can move the photo layer around so that the object is aligned with the vertical guide in the document. So now that I've got it in the ballpark, I want to zoom in so that I can make sure that I'm as close to the center as possible. So I'm zooming in just a little bit, and I'm going to drag out a new guideline. And when I place that guideline on the edge of the document here, I can see that I'm about 5.7 to the center here. If I drag out another one and put it on this edge of the wine glass, I'm about 5.3 on this side. So I'm a little bit heavy on this side. And what I'll do is move the photograph off to the left here to try to split the difference. So now when I bring the guide back in, about 5.5 and roughly 5.5 on that side. So by zooming in, I can make minor adjustments to try to match the distance from the center on both sides so that the wine glass is symmetrically aligned with the center line of the document. Now that I've done that, I can zoom back out and I can lock this layer so that I don't accidentally move it when I make the same adjustments on the second layer. And I can turn off the visibility of that layer and select the second layer, and I'm going to rename that to be top. And I'm going to do the same thing in that layer. I can select that and use my move tool to roughly align the center of this rim. And I'm looking now just at the rim of the glass. You can see that when I took this photograph that the stem of the glass is not perfectly aligned with the rim. So I'm going to use the rim of the photograph to try to center it in this document. And I'm going to drag the existing guides into the rim of the glass. And on the right side, it looks like I'm roughly 4.5. And here I'm a little bit too right heavy, so I can move the document over. Try to realign my guides. See how close I'm getting now. Maybe a little bit too far. I can walk it in now by using my arrow keys and try to get it as close to, it looks like 4.2. And I'll do the same thing on the top and bottom. It should also be 4.2 there. A little top heavy here, so I'll drag that down. I'm going to use my arrow key to step it down. And again, that's pretty close. So I'll use that. Again, zoom back out. And so now I have my two layers that are aligned to the center of the document. And I'll lock that so I don't change that by accident either. So now that everything's aligned and I have both layers locked, I'm going to save it once as a Photoshop document. And I'll come into the dialog box and say it as Photoshop, and I'll name it Wine Glass. Save it once as a Photoshop document with the layers. And then I can save two different JPEG files, one for each layer. So I'm selecting the top layer and making that visible. And I'll do a file, save as. And I'm choosing the format as JPEG. And I'm going to call this one Wine Front. Save that as a JPEG. Then I'll hide that layer and do the same thing and save the top view as a JPEG. And I'll call that Wine Top. Now that I've saved both of those views as JPEGs, and I can show you that here in the Finder, the next step of the process is to bring those images into Maya, where I can use them as image planes to start building my model to scale. And I'll show you that process in part 3 of the tutorial. You can find the link to part 3 of the tutorial in the description below.